Now the third method of adding a pedestal to your bowl is using a coil. I've rolled out this big coil. I do have an extruder that extrudes a perfectly round coil this way, but I thought not everyone has access to an extruder, and it felt like cheating. So anyway, so I'm going to score with my center lines and attach this coil. This is not my favorite method. I find that unless your coil is an absolute perfect coil, it's harder to center it because it's thick and thin, thick and thin, thick and thin, thick and thin. Blech. Easy for me to say. Also, this pot's a little wetter than I would like it to be. I usually would let it firm up a bit more. However, I mentioned my blogs. I do have a part-time post office job that starts in 2 hours. Jim's here with the camera, and we're going to do this. So this could be a demonstration of how to use a coil to throw into a pedestal base, or it could be what happens when you push it. I'm just going to find out, because this is a little wetter than my comfort zone. And again, as I mentioned in both, they aren't the amount, same amount of water content. I'm using my score lines to center. I'm going to cross them over, cut them at an angle, get rid of the top and get rid of the bottom, join them together. With a dry thumb, the same way I did with the piece I centered, I'm going to join that around. If you don't use a dry thumb, or if your thumb gets wet, dry it off. This gets all slidey. And on the inside, but as you can see, my walls are thick and thin, and it's a bit more of a challenge centering and working with a clay, coil of clay that's not the same thickness all the way around. I can add some water, and now we're going to see if I can get away with throwing this. You see where that joins is a bump. See if I can get away with throwing this. I'm going to throw it up a little bit. And if you can get it centered, all the unevenness comes to the top, and then you can just get rid of that. So it's getting, I call it, it's like centered. Gonna tidy it up a little bit. Again, these thrown pedestals tend to be a smaller base for your bowl to sit on. You see it's not that centered. I'm going to pull it out. I'm going to give this one a little bit different profile this time, just because I can. Well, the bowl didn't collapse, and the piece threw fairly well. That's a pretty little, I don't like that base at all. I'm going to pull that out a little bit. Pretty not meaning attractive, but too small for my taste. Again, these pedestal bowls are your own taste. I do like to, with my spoon, you can either just use it as a nice rib to get rid of that, or all my pedestal bowls always have that signature spoon. Signature spoon, what do you want to use? Signature spoon trough, signature spoon groove. They're groovy bowls. Anyway, I'm going to make, there are my groovy bowls. Just trying to decide if I want two groovies or three groovies. This is a three groovy bowl. Now you can see it's not that centered. A three groovy bowl sitting on a little base. Sounds like a rock band from the 60s. Anyway. So there's throwing the coil. It didn't fall down. I normally wouldn't have thrown it that wet, but we did pedestal bowls. We threw the pedestal. I attached it. I put a little ball on. I threw a pedestal. Then I put a coil on, my least favorite, and I didn't collapse the bowl. So there are pedestal bowls.